part of the problem is the awareness trends, and we've all talked about that, that women are not aware that heart disease is their number one risk. I can't tell you how many times I have heard a woman come into my office and say, I was told I was anxious, I was told I was stressed, I was told it's in my head, but I think something's wrong. And there is such thing as that woman's intuition. Because 90% of the time after a woman had a heart event and I asked, did you know it was your heart? She says, I kind of had a feeling. Doctors aren't referring women as much as they're referring men for life-saving things like stress testing and cardiac angiograms. And we've heard this data already. But it becomes a problem because as doctors, if we don't refer the patients, then we can't deliver them perhaps what can save their lives. Here's another issue. There are actually guidelines on women and heart disease prevention. There is a lack of awareness among physicians, but for those that do have an awareness, and the guidelines are on the right-hand side, the cardiologists are most aware, but many women do not have cardiologists. I'm not gonna put you on the spot, but a lot of times when I ask women who their primary caregiver is, it's their gynecologist. When we look about how medicine is delivered, we look at three different parts, the research, the doctors, and the patient. And when it comes down to the research, believe it or not, and I was actually looking at some of those slides that were up, they were really based on men. And most of the research on heart disease are based on men. And that data is extrapolated, and we deliver it to our women patients. A woman will go in with the same risk factors that a man will, and she won't get the same treatment. Now, I'm not saying all this to scare you or get you angry about all the doctors, because it's not necessary. But what is necessary is that you become your own advocate. Before you go in, know what you want to say, know what your complaints are. If you're going to a cardiologist, don't talk about your sore elbow. Put that on the bottom of the list. Don't talk about the things that don't pertain to what that doctor's expertise is, but go in there and say, I am having trouble exercising. I am getting shortness of breath. I am getting fatigue every time I try to walk up the stairs. Be very clear and pointed.